We were always laughing, and I've been on a lot of sets, and I was on all the Paramount shows, those Star Trek shows over there, Deep Space Nine and Next Generation. They're wonderful, you know, great. But Babylon 5 had this whole other, I don't know, it's hard to put my finger on it, but it really was a bunch of really smart, talented, and kind people. There was no ego, right? There was no... It didn't matter if it was Bruce or if it was me or if it was the guest star or if it was one of the crew members. Everyone talked. We all sat together and ate. There was no segregation. And there was no star trailer and guest star trailer. All the trailers were the same size. And on set, it was like that. So my favorite thing, besides that I always felt included and everyone felt included, was that it was so funny. Everything was funny. And... You get a group of talented, smart, witty people together. It's just a joy, you know. Our director of photography was just one of the funniest men I'd ever met. Oh my gosh, it was such a blessing. We'd have new directors come on to direct the show because you know how they alternate directors between episodes, and they would just be blown away by how well we all worked together and the levity. It was just calm. You know, we just had it, and we knew we had it. And even if the scene was tough or we were, you know, struggling with the clock, oh, my God, we had only this much time to get something done, nobody got bitchy or blamed anybody. No one blamed each other. You know, we were a team. And I know maybe that sounds obvious, that people should always be like this, but it was so rare in Hollywood in my experience that I could go, I never went to work stressed out. I went to work excited. So Babylon 5 was done for just like the change in the producers' pockets, right? It was not a real show. And so they weren't going to give us real money. So they, instead of renting a soundstage, they converted a warehouse that was, and for the entire time that we were there, they never changed the sign. It said Orange Bang on it. It was the Orange Bang building. And the only way that we knew that it was anything but was because it had an alien crossing sign at the parking lot. It was just, had the... had a Kosh, had a Mimbari, and a Pakmara crossing. But the building itself was not designed for shooting anything in, and we often would have to stop when airplanes went overhead. But right next door and sharing the parking lot was a recycling dump that one time Bill Mumy, one of our producers, and maybe it was Mira's car as well. Their cars were parked in the very back of the parking lot, and the recycling dump did something with a bunch of spray paint, and it went all over their cars. So they had the recycling dump had to pay for the repainting of I think Bruce's Jaguar, and oh my God, it was bad. Anyway, it smelled like a recycling dump, and that's where we would eat. Because the tents were set up in the parking lot. I lost a lot of weight on Babylon 5. But we had tents that were in rain or shine, that's where we ate, everybody all together.